So how many of you out there are big Death Note fans? I know me personally, I love Death Note. I'm a big fan of Death Note. And I wanted today to talk about the little news that recently came out regarding the Death Note American live action adaption. Apparently, the writer and director for Iron Man 3 might have some big involvement with this particular movie. He basically mentioned that he has this thing down at Warner Brothers called Death Note. He's really liking it. And basically, it's been confirmed for a bit, or has been announced, that Warner Brothers had the rights to do a Death Note live action. Now, obviously, they have to put it on the back burner for movies like Iron Man 3 because, you know, that becomes a huge focus when they're doing things like that. But I checked out dude's credentials, and he seems to have some pretty notable movies under his belt. He did the Lethal Weapon 1. He did Long Kiss Goodnight. He's done some different things aside from Iron Man 3. So, dude sounds like he's okay in his resume for doing things. But my biggest fear with this movie, I'm going to be 100% honest with you guys, is that they're going to do this. If they do this, you don't understand the rage that is going to come out of many, many people, because this is hands down probably the worst, if not top three worst live action adaptions ever. Dragon Ball Evolution, many of you may know, it was really just bad as an adaption, wasn't really a thought out movie. Overall, they just did a terrible job. And that's really one of my biggest fears with the Death Note live action, and as well as the Bleach live action that Warner Brothers also has confirmed a while back. They are in development with a Bleach live action. They have the rights to it, at least. And the thing about it is, with Death Note, there's a little bit more of a safer bet with it. With Dragon Ball, you gotta figure, okay, what arc are we gonna adapt? Where we're going to start at, are we going to get backstory, where we're going to, you know, the location. There's a lot of things that go into Dragon Ball, the CG for all the Kamehamehas, the blast and everything like that. There's a lot of different things. And one of the bigger things as well with the Dragon Ball live action is that Dragon Ball Z is huge in America, but they didn't want to start off at Dragon Ball Z because that's an even bigger CG budget. So they wanted to start off with Dragon Ball. And in all honesty, it was just really a catastrophe with that movie. Death Note is a little more of a safer bet. 12 volumes, straight story. You know, sometimes a lot of people like to break it up into two parts with the first half and the second half. And for the most part, the biggest problems you have, I guess, when going in there is one, the CG for the Shinigamis. Like, you know, how you're going to do the CG for the Shinigamis and whatnot, which isn't a big deal because it's not like there's billions of them or anything. There's only a select few that show up. And mainly that, and as well as, are you going to do two movies? Are you going to do one movie with a cliffhanger? You know, how you going to do that? The Japanese did a live action of Death Note. They did two movies. They did movie one and two of Death Note in live action, and they basically told the story that way. But mind you, these are actually some pretty good adaptions. But with this American adaption, I'm more so wanting them to just do one movie, to be honest with you, because if they leave it off in a cliffhanger, we don't know when we'll get the next one and who will be directing and writing it. And we could end up with one really good movie, one really solid movie, and one really terrible movie. Not to mention that a lot of people do say that they find, including myself, the second half is a bit weaker than the first half for Death Note. So it would be a catastrophe if they did the movie in two parts, in my opinion. Because, you know, when they're adapting stuff in America from Japan, a lot of times it comes out bad. Again, Dragon Ball Evolution. So for this particular project, me personally, I want one movie. I want one Death Note movie. Tell the story the best way you possibly can. If you got to cut some stuff out, you know, even if you have to cut a couple of characters that aren't that important out, I don't mind. You know, at the end of the day, it is an adaption. It can't be straight up, you know, manga panel for panel adapted onto screen. But I just think that it'd be a safer bet to get one movie, to be honest with you. And as far as actors go, I'm not really picky as long as they look more or less like the characters and they can act. I know it's been a big rumor that Zac Efron is supposed to be playing Light, or he's been asked if he would like to play Light or something like that. He looks like him from previous works. He's never shown that type of ability to act like Light, because, you know, Light has this certain personality, and Zac Efron, for the most part, always just shows this, like, campy, yay, I'm happy. So, if they do cast him, I just hope his acting chops have built up from what he was to what he is, because from the little things I have seen of him, he doesn't seem like he fits the role as far as, like, acting-wise, but looks-wise, he does look like Light. And overall, just I just want the actors to at least look a little like the characters, you know, more or less, have, you know, similarities, and ultimately act really good. I don't want, like, Justin Chatwin in this movie. No offense to Justin Chatwin, because I'm sure he did what he could, but That was not a good pick for Goku, in my opinion. He wasn't ready for it. He just wasn't ready for the amazingness of Dragon Ball. And ultimately, with this Death Note movie, I want them to do the best that they possibly can. And even if it isn't the greatest movie or anything, which it probably won't be, because let's face it, how many, can you even count on one hand, anime movie adaptions that have been amazing, incredible, critics have raved over it? Not really, but I'm just hoping for something satisfactory. I'm hoping, since they got a big name, like, you know, the Iron Man 3 director under their belt, that will mean something with his previous works and stuff like that, and ultimately that we just get a good movie, because like I said, I'm a huge Death Note fan. I got the entire anime, I got the live actions, I got the manga, I even bought the Black Edition. So, you know, I'm a huge Death Note fan, so I have some expectations for this, but I'm not going to put them too high, because with you know, previous experience of American adaptions of Japanese, you know, cartoons and Japanese comic books and anime and manga, I know that it can go really, really south. And I think that's the best way for anybody that is a Death Note fan that is going into this movie, or, you know, when they finally start releasing stuff from it, to go into it with a mindset of, you know, hopefully they do a decent job. Because that way, if it ends up crashing and burning, whatever. If it ends up being great, it blows your expectations out the water, and even better. So that's really my main take on this whole thing. I'm just hoping for something at least satisfactory. And I'm hoping that they do the best job that they possibly can. Because with Dragon Ball, it started off with a $100 million budget, ends up a $30 million budget, and the director of the movie isn't even there on set. It's on paper. So, you know, I hate to keep harping on that, but Dragon Ball Evolution is a way this movie can go, and what I'm hoping it ultimately does it. Because I want Death Note to be what it ultimately is. I want to see Light in his maniacal ways. I want to see L in his crazy, quirky ways. And I just want to see a really good stuff. You know, I want to see Misa in there. I want to see greatness from this movie. But my expectations are, just give me satisfactory and I'll be alright with it. What do you guys think? Any particular actors you want to see play a certain role for a particular character? Misa, make her attractive. Get a really attractive actress, because I think Misa kind of portrays that, you know, she was like an idol and stuff like that. So for those particular things, I like, you know, just get a certain type. But what do you guys think? Any actors? And as far as your expectations for this, do you expect greatness? Do you expect, you know, terrible? What is your expectations on this? Because now, you know, we got the Iron Man 3 director, screenwriter involved, so it could mean something good, hopefully. And, you know, like I said, Death Note isn't that hard of a story, I think, to adapt. You have the source material right there. It's not that hard. It's not a place you gotta pick to adapt. You can just adapt it, you know. 12 volumes, come on, 12 volumes, it shouldn't be that difficult. Again, overall thoughts, are you excited for this? Because hopefully this means within the next couple of years we can see something, and I'm just hoping for something, you know, to feel good, man. I need that Death Note again. I love Death Note. Oh, and one more thing I wanted to ask, if anybody is a, you know, a hardcore manga reader out there, I've been looking for the next Death Note, something that is similar to Death Note with the style of it, the darkness, the psychological battles. If anybody knows a good manga like that, shoot me a comment letting me know. I would love to read it. Just saying. But that's all I have for this one. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed. Thumbs up if you're hoping that this Death Note movie can at least be satisfying. Because that's all we ask for. That's all I ask for. I'm Forever One. As always, people, have an awesome day.